Hey guys, what's up? So in last video we have seen that we were getting error index out of bond in this Excel code. So how to solve that? See, the problem what happens is there is a two problem here. One is we don't want this data, okay, because this data is just a headers. Our the main data is this two data, okay, so we need to ignore the first data. Now what happens is when we run this, when this while loop is getting run, no matter whether this is this data, username, header or something, I is getting increased, which we don't want. So we cannot write I++ here. How we should write is, first time anyways we are going to break this while loop. When the second time when the this data come, your I value should be 0 only. It should be 0 comma 0, 0 comma 1. Then second set of data it should go 1 comma 0, right? So that way we should handle. So I we should not write here. So what we should do? How we should handle it? To handle that, what we can do when this while loop is breaking, okay, it breaks here basically. So the moment first time this iteration will get over, then at the end go and increase the data. So remove from here, come back, and we can basically write here, okay. So when we write here, what happens is first your all iteration got over and then data is getting incremented at the end, right? But again this will have a drawback, I know that, okay. This will also will have a drawback, I know that. If I'll run this again, you will get same error index out of bond. If you look at, let it run. So you can see that this time, at least what happened this time is first set of data got printed and then you got error index out of bond, okay. First set of data got printed and then you got error index out of bond. Let me run in the debug mode to show you. Run as testng. I am running in the debug mode and I have already kept the debugger there, so it will wait, which I have shown in my previous video. So it is waiting here. Now here it is waiting, so click on next, click on F6, so first time it will break. See, though we are breaking the first time username, the header, still the problem is I is getting incremented. Now if you look at, I became already 1, right? But it should not be 1, now it should be 0, because still your this data set has no data, still you have not kept the data in the data set, okay. So now click on F6. See, the problem what happens is your 0 cell will get overruled, okay. Keep the data first, press F6. You should be good in, very good into debugging, so that you can analyze the problem. Yeah, come back now. Now look at the data set. See, this is the problem. Your first one got skipped. Why? Because your I became 1. So when you say 1, your 0 row will get skipped, right? Which means what we have to do now, you will get error index out of bond because I became now 2 and you don't have, see, I became, one second, let me run one more time, okay. Now I will become 2. See, this is the problem. Now what is the I value? I value became 2. Now you will get error index out of bond because your array is already full. Now there is no space in the array because your first index, 0 index row got skipped. To handle that, see, now the moment you will go there, you will get this error index out of bond. See, already exception came. So how do you handle that? See, the problem we now know. What is the problem? Problem is the size is more than what we have specified. So how to handle that? Very easy. when it should be 1, it is becoming 2. When it should be 0, it is becoming 1, right? So, we can reduce 1 here. This will handle all the problem. Okay, internally we will reduce 1. So, when it is 2, it will become automatically 1. When it is 1, automatically it will become 0. Okay, and there will not be any case where I is going to be 0 because of this culprit. Because we have to increment, there is no other way. We have to have, right? There is no other way. So now, when let's say now either you write here, yeah, I mean, this is the good way, you write it here at the end. So now, when it is a 1 after the first iterations, so when we are reading the header, this will break. When this will break and this I plus plus is the outside of this while loop, still this I will get called. So even though it is breaking, I becomes 1, right? But in the second iterations, we have to make I again back to the 0. So this conditions will work out, okay? This conditions will work out. Now run the test. Now your test should run 2 times. Run as test ng. See, now your test should run 2 times. It should do a login. Yeah, it should do mouse over sign out. Yeah, it did a sign out. Again, it will do a login. Again, it will do a sign out. So your data driven framework is now ready to rock. Okay. Now we'll be adding some more scripts. We'll do lot of things in this framework, lot of reporting and all that. Now we can see that at least TestNG report will be generated. So if I refresh this, in the test output, we can see that emailed report, at least TestNG by default report will be generated. See, two tests got executed with this parameter. Okay, with this parameter. So thank you guys, thank you for watching this. This code will be uploaded. Okay, and even you try to put effort from your side so that you learn fast. Thank you guys.